The body of Christ don't need to lay casually around while people are lost and dying and not being delivered from drugs and stuff like that, and just letting Satan take them out one by one. Millions of people, if we could look into the spirit world, if we could see, people departing this life by the thousands every day. Yes, people being born into this life, but people departing, leaving this world every day. And you wonder how many of them has got their heart right with the Lord. How many is going to heaven? Or how many is going to that awful, awful place called hell that you don't want anybody to go there? Church, it's time to get on fire. It's time to preach God's word, the true word of God, like we've never preached it before. If you have to cry and beg, if you have to do that to make people see the light, to make people realize that they need to change their life and change their hearts, and you've not done anything that's too bad that the Lord won't forgive you. He'll forgive you of anything that you have done. Anything. Jesus told the religious people. They accused him of casting out devils by the prince of the devils. Jesus told them, how can Satan cast out Satan? If a house be divided against itself, it can't stand. And then he proceeded to tell them the one sin that they would not get forgiveness of, and that's blasphemy against the Holy Ghost. There's people in institutions today, mental institutions, that think they've blasphemed against the Holy Ghost. If you don't know what that is, you've probably never done it. You've probably never done it if you don't know what that is. And if you did say something in ignorance or something, God is a merciful God. But when you know the Word of God and what the Word of God said about the Holy Ghost, and when you purposely say something about it, no, you won't get forgiveness of that. But anything else, I don't care what it is, you'll be forgiven. I don't care if you've been married 15 times, God will forgive you. I'll tell you what, I don't care if you've sinned, whatever, murder, anything else. Molestation, right? Just to name some of the sins that we classify as greater than other sins, but God sees it all as sin. He'll forgive you. He will forgive you. He sure will. Praise God. So people in jail today, God will forgive you. If you'll call on Him, ask you to forgive, ask God to forgive you of your sins, He'll say forgiven. You can be a new creature today, praise God. God will give you a brand new heart and a brand new start, everlasting life, praise God, hallelujah. So don't let it pass by today. Don't let the opportunity pass by you if the Lord is tugging at your heart. If you feel like praying, pray. Ask God into your heart. Ask Him to come in to your heart, to save you, forgive you of all your sins, and He'll do it. And I know that a lot of people has heard this before, but some haven't. Some haven't heard it. That's the reason we repeat a lot of stuff, because there's people out there that's never heard it, that's just hearing it for the first time. Praise God. Ask the Lord into your heart. He's a good God, and He's surely worth serving. And then be serious about your salvation. Christians, get on the right road. Get serious about your salvation. Serious about the Lord. Because there is unprofitable servants that the Bible says will be cast out. There is people, religious people, that'll receive a greater damnation, a more severe punishment, because they led people astray, because they got them wrapped up in old religious stuff, didn't preach them the true word of God. The Bible says in the last days that people would have itching ears, and they would gather together teachers to tell them what they want to hear. Oh, you're just the best thing. You're just the apple of God's eye. He just loves you now. And, you know, you just feel good about yourself, you know. Motivational speakers. Just to motivate you, tell you how good you are and how wonderful you are. Well, that's all good if the Lord says that. But sometimes there's a word of correction. There's a word of correction. We don't like to say that. We don't like to do that. But you know what? Sometimes God has us do it. And you know what? Realize when the Lord is speaking that it's God speaking. Don't sit by just, you know, ho-hum, you know. You know, and roll your eyes around. Stuff like that, you know. Just like, nah, that's just them. I know them. They work down the, you know, they work down Walmart or, you know, they work down at the drugstore or somewhere like that or hospital. You take it as the word of God.